What color is this spinning top? I mean, it looks white, or maybe gray, but when it stops spinning, we can see it's actually a whole heap of different colors. How is this possible? Let's find out by making this spinning top at home. Are you ready? Then let's get science. To make the spinning top, you'll need
cardboard, old pencils, 4 large coins, a printout of these colored patterns, scissors, a glue stick, a hot glue gun, and an adult to help you.
I've added a link for this printout to the description. If you're able to, try to get it printed at a stationery or printing shop.
The colors will look a lot nicer and the effect will work much better.
Once you've printed this out, carefully cut around the colored circles with a pair of scissors. Use these colored circles to trace out 4 more circles onto your cardboard and then cut these circles out. Next, glue the colored circles onto the cardboard circles, making sure the edges line up. Once the glue has dried, take some old pencils that are about 8 centimeters long and poke them through the middle of the colored circles. Lastly, use a hot glue gun to glue 4 large coins an equal distance apart on the bottom of the spinning top. Glue the pencils to the cardboard as well. This will help it to spin better. And that's it. Time to test these spinning tops out. Whoa! The printout contains 2 types of colored patterns. Give both of these a try to see which one you like the best. So, what's happening? To explain this, we need to talk about 2 things: white light and persistence of vision.
Let's start with white light. The light from the sun is an example of white light. It appears colorless, but if we pass this light through a prism, it gets split up into a whole heap of colors. From red to orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet.
So sunlight is actually made up of all these colors of light, which we call the visible spectrum, and even a few types of light that we can't see, such as infrared and ultraviolet.
When these colors combine together, they appear white or colorless to our eyes.
So the first thing to remember is that combining all the colors of light from across the visible spectrum produces white light. Now, let's talk about persistence of vision. We see an object because light enters our eyes either directly from the source or indirectly by bouncing off the object and then into our eyes.
A signal is then sent from our eyes to our brain, and our brain turns this into the images we see. These images stay in our brain for a really short time, less than a second. They don't disappear instantly, and this is known as persistence of vision. You've probably noticed persistence of vision before if you've ever moved a sparkler around really quickly. If you do this, you won't see a single bright spot, but a bright streak. That's because you're still seeing the image of the sparkler from here, even when the sparkler is over here.
So, what's happening when we spin the spinning top?
The disc has a range of colors from across the visible spectrum. When the disc is spinning slowly, you can see the individual colors quite easily and separately from each other. But as the disc spins faster and faster, it becomes harder to see the individual colors. Instead of your eye detecting red light in this spot, the disc is moving so fast that it detects red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. Due to persistence of vision, our brain keeps the image of all these colors from this spot and combines them together. And as we saw before, our brain interprets this combination of colors as white light. It might look a little bit gray due to the printed inks absorbing some of the light, but if you do it outside on a bright day, it will look pretty close to white.
Thanks for watching this episode of Silly Science with Simon.